Hi everyone and thanks for watching. So in this tutorial I'll be using some shin guards. They're made from plastic and the first thing I'll need to do is use some acetone to clean them and remove all the glue that was left onto the backside. So it's quite easy, it's quite straightforward. So you just take a fresh piece of paper, grip it in some acetone and then you can just remove all the glue that was left on the backside of the part. And also remove any dirt that was left on the shin guards. So the next thing is use some sanding paper just to make them as smooth as possible. It doesn't have to be perfect, but it is always better to have something good to work on to make your first mold. So I go up in grit from 80 till 400, you can even go higher. But my plan was to sand the molds after making the molds. So here I'm taking 400 as last step. So at the end, after sanding, you always need to use some acetone or something just to clean the parts before you will make the molds. So no dirt is left on the parts. So the next thing you'll need to do is fill all the holes where resin can drip through or pass through. So you have to avoid to have some undercuts into your mold. So if I wouldn't fill those holes, resin will drip through and it would be quite difficult, maybe impossible to remove the part at the end. The next step will be to close the gaps at the bottom and top of the part. So for that I'm using some modeling clay. You have to work quite fast because it will dry out, so once water is out of the clay it will become hard, shrink and so on. So you have to work fast. It's quite easy to do, it's very cheap and it works with most polyester resins and epoxy resins as well, I think. So it's quite straightforward. You just make sure you have no undercuts, so it means the part should be easily to pull out of the mold at the end. So this is how it should look like. So it's done with a chamfer, so the part won't be stuck inside. So the next step you'll need to do is use some wax. I'm using some high temperature wax from Meguiar and on the left you see the trend spray from Foschimi. So next thing you can do in meanwhile, you can cut some fiberglass that I'll be using to fill the undercuts at the sides of the mold. So in between the layers you just add 4 layers of wax and wait 15 minutes in between till it dries out, so it's around when it gets dry and it has a white look. So as last step, I always like to use a trench spray just to make sure that the part will come off easily out of the mold. So it's very straightforward, so you just spray it on like you would do with a simple spray can. You make sure you fill the entire parts with the release agents, and mostly I do 2 coats and wait 15 minutes in between. So up to the next step. So now we're ready for the laminating of the parts. So make sure you work safely, use a mask, gloves, and so on. So this is everything I'll need. So I have my pot with the fiberglass, cut it in small pieces. This is a 300 and 400 gram square meter, and that's about it. So then you mix your resin, and then I'll add a little bit of resin with the fiberglass strand. So this is what I'm doing right now. I'm taking a bit, it's quite dense, so it's in fact it's polyester resin with some fiberglass, and this enables me to fill the undercuts with some fiberglass and polyester resin. Next step is just put some resin onto the top of the shin guards and add some fiberglass. So I always like to start with it 30 gram square meter on top just to have a nice finish on the bottom of the mold, and then build up some thickness with the 400 grams and then finish again with 30 grams just to have a nice finish on the outside of the mold as well. So here I'm just using I don't know how it's called. It's just to remove all the air from inside of layers. So by going onto the parts, it will remove all the air trapped inside. So this is how it looks like after the laminating. And then the next step will be to put it into an oven, just to speed up the process of hardening. So I put it around 50 degrees, wait for a few hours, then get it out, and it should be hard and ready to demold. So the part should normally come off easily. The part was coming off easily, but it was a clay that was sticking onto the part, so that's why it was a bit difficult to remove the part. So this is how it should look like. So the clay could dry out a bit because it went into an oven, but in my case the clay was still wet and good to be removed. So it could be you have some flanges of resin going onto the inside, but that isn't a big problem. It can easily be sanded off or cut off at the end. So here I'm removing the parts. It's easy to be removed because there is some flex into the part. So if this was a hard piece, I wouldn't be able to remove it. So it's very important to keep that in mind. So at the end, you just remove all the excess that was still left into the mold, and you should have a nice mold at the end. Thanks for watching. You can check the other parts by clicking on the video on top of the screen. And in the next video, I'll show you how to make the plug where we will make the mold of. If you like what I'm doing and want to see some more, have a look at my Facebook page and give it a like. And if you really like my videos, please subscribe for more updates on my following projects. And don't forget to like or comment for some feedback or questions. So up to the next video. Bye.